Well, joining us today for our Talanoa is Flora Apulu, who's the chairperson for the Auckland Council Youth Advisory Panel. Tāna whālawa. And Riki Welsh, who is a member of the Youth Action Committee. Thank you, Riki and Flora, for joining us.
Good morning.
And I just have to say, your hair, oh my gosh, how much gel do you put in your hair every day?
Oh, 3 puddles of wax a week.
Wow.
That was the most asked question of me at the conference.
Wow. Well, it definitely makes an impact. Firstly, how was the conference? What can you take away from it?
I think the conference went really well overall. I mean, I'm really looking forward to the outcomes that will come out from this conference. But yeah, overall, I think it went really well. It was a really unique conference because, you know, it was youth driven and youth led. But yeah, Leva's got a great team. So,
Riki, what are Pacific people, what are the challenges that our youth are facing today?
I think what came across clearly at the conference was living in two different worlds was the biggest challenge. Mm. So at home, it's all about the collective and the family, and then you step outside and you need individual responsibility. Mm. And neither one of those sides appreciates the other one, and so that's the confusing space we get stuck in.
Well, how do we merge the gap between you know, the older generation?
Because it's not a new challenge. Yeah. I think it's something that, you know, has always been there for other Pacific generations.
I think it's about just finding a balance, or kind of like a place where we can come together and say, you know, I'm living in New Zealand, I'm also part I'm Samoan, you know, and yes. How do we find that middle ground where our young people can not go through an identity crisis in between, but just feel that they have the strengths of both worlds as well. So, yeah, it's not about losing who we are, it's about using who we are. Okay. To really help us. So.
Yeah. What about the expectations from parents as well? Is that like a big issue for young people?
Yeah, the expectations definitely, because they expect their kids to do well in school, but to do that they have to be a different person to what they're taught at home. They have to be cutthroat, they have to be ruthless and know what they want and go and get it, but what they've been taught at home is, no, you're part of a group, we're interdependent on each other, and so those expectations are hard to balance.
Okay.
Now that brings me to the next topic, suicide. Now that's obviously some issues that our young people are facing today. What are some of the solutions, you know, that was discussed at the conference?
Really, talking was a big one, and being able to talk to our elders and our matua about suicide. The statistics in the suicide session was appalling. It was really, really painful to hear a lot of those things. And everyone, of course, even our elders are saying, no, we need to fix this, we need to talk more. But actually what we did see was, you say one thing, but our attitudes are still doing another thing.
Okay then. What are some of the other issues that were raised at the conference?
There was definitely stuff about youth culturally appropriate services for Pacifica young people. Yeah. And it wasn't so much about them having issues with accessibility, but it was more the services being appropriate, culturally appropriate for them, and stuff like that. So
that brings me to this new technology. I mean, there's the use of social media
and
nowadays.
You're big on that, aren't you?
Well, thank you very much, Marama. But that's also a new ground that our young people are facing as well. There's also threats. I mean, you know, also the pros and cons of using
Did you guys talk about that a lot?
Yeah, definitely. Cyberbullying is a big thing, not just for young people, actually. Adults are cyberbullying each other because they don't know how to use it properly.
Yeah.
But in terms of technology and stuff, there's some great things coming through. We're using apps now to help with mental suicide prevention. The Auntie D app has been launched by Levar, and that's a great way for our young people to be able to help solve some of the issues.
Oh, okay. Very good.
Thank you both for coming on the show. We really appreciate your time.
Cool, thank you for having us.
Totally love it. Now, stay with us. When we come back, two young paddlers separated by an ocean have their sights on the same dream.
Winning with the boys in the six man, and also winning both the singles races. It was hard, the preparation, but got there in the end.